Hello, 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 everyone. We're gonna be continuing Star Ocean today. We were at Old Earth last week. And we'll be continuing from where we left off. So let's see how far we can get today. There's a save point over there, there's a save point over there. But there's only like one entrance. So I guess we have to go over there.
This place is deserted.
It sure is, and has been for some time from the looks of things.
For now, let's split up and see what we can uncover. Report if you find anything.
Huh? What? This can't be.
Judging from the color degradation caused by ultraviolet rays, I'd say it's been abandoned for about 3 years. I suppose that's not particularly important, but...
Well, don't jump to conclusions, FaZe. If nothing else, I just figured out when we are. The date on this magazine is too faded to read, but there was an article inside that caught my attention. 2 years after initial experiments, our country has at last perfected the ultimate doomsday weapon. The hydrogen bomb, is what it says. If I remember my history, the first practical hydrogen bomb on Earth was developed in 1954. So basically, if you're saying this magazine is 3 years old, that would put us in the year 1957. In other words, we're on the Earth of nearly 150 years ago.
The Earth of 150 years ago? That's not even possible.
I'm not so certain, Mr. FaZe.
What? Even you, Bacchus?
Mr. Edge, a short time ago I intercepted some radio waves, albeit weak ones.
Radio waves? Like old broadcast radio?
The transmission was as follows. Some days ago, the historic honor of launching the first artificial satellite slipped through our fingers, instead going to the Reds. This unfortunate occurrence has prompted the president to announce new plans for manned rocket missions, promising to put men in space before our rivals. Mr. Edge, how would you interpret this information?
Anyone who's ever dreamed of going into outer space knows the story. The first successful launch of a man-made satellite was... the middle of the last century, 1957. No wonder we can't reach anyone. In 1957, the USTA wasn't even a twinkle in someone's eye. Honestly, I can't believe it. But with this much evidence piling up, I guess we have no choice but to face reality. The planet we made our emergency landing on may be Earth, but it's an Earth from almost 150 years in the past. Didn't you mention this sort of thing before, FaZe? An error in mid-warp that can cause a ship to end up in another time entirely?
No, this situation is somewhat different. That was brought about by the distortion caused by warping within the space-time continuum. The dangers associated with it are nothing more than arriving earlier or later on the standard temporal axis. If the theory we're positing here is true, it would be time regression. And such a thing is absolutely not possible.
Apparently it is.
Though, with the situation as it is, I hesitate to apply the term absolutely.
Hmm. If we posit that time regression has indeed occurred, it would mean we're now located in a space topologically distinct from that in which we were previously. In the current situation, I do not yet have enough information to say whether such a thing is even possible. But if the reality is that we now stand upon the past Earth, we have no choice but to accept it as fact.
So, let me get this straight. We've been transported to the Earth of 150 years in the past. And we currently have no way of getting back, right?
If this truly is the Earth of another time, then yes. I'm afraid there is nothing we can do to return.
The only thing I can say for certain is this. It's pointless to keep standing around here. Let's return to the Calnus and review the situation together. Then we can decide what to do. What?
Yeah, I always forget to hydrate. Thank you for that. But I also put a 15 minute cooldown timer on it this time.
The Calnus! Damn it! What did they get here?
Welcome in, Nether. How are you doing?
Soldiers of some sort.
No, that is not unfair, because I do want to have my drinks surviving the whole night.
It would seem this was more than just a ghost town.
This isn't let's swap theories time. Raimi and Limmel are still inside.
Wait.
You're doing good. What have you been up to today?
All they want is to capture the extraterrestrials inside. If nothing else, I can assure you no one will be harmed.
Just by 40 cans and you're good. Though bathroom breaks will ramp up, yep. That is what I had last time.
You refer to us as extraterrestrials quite casually.
Are you with those soldiers over there?
And having 40 cans, then that's nothing.
My name is Klaus Bachtein. You have to trust me. I'm your friend.
Oh, Sly Cooper. Which one? Like the first one, or Steve in Time, I don't know. Which one?
I must request an explanation. On what ground should we consider you to be our friend?
Fair enough. But first we must find a better place to talk.
Sly Cooper 1 finished it now, I'm working on number 2. Oh, that is nice. I still have to play those games. Like I did Sly 1. But
I'll give you the details there.
Never beaten it.
Edge, are you really going to trust him?
We must keep in mind that this may be a trap.
Or he might really want to help us. If nothing else, he presented himself to us unarmed. Besides,
when I was young, a long time ago, I played the ever living out of Sly Cooper franchise. I love this franchise. It is a nice looking game, good gameplay.
That is very like Mr. Edge.
Yes, I am true.
And like I said, I still need to finish those games. And I will. I will, eventually. Yeah, I will stream them as soon as I get to them. However, I still have like a lot of games in planning.
For a moment, I thought it really was a trap.
But still, what are you doing here, Limmel?
Yeah, weren't you staying in the Calnus?
No, I have the games physical, so.
It's all my fault.
I have them on PS3.
What exactly happened, Limmel?
I'll see.
Allow me to explain.
I see. So that's what this is all about. Your country's army has troops stationed at a base here, and the ruined town serves to camouflage it.
Interesting. So the men surrounding the Countess were indeed soldiers after all.
I'm an old school gamer too. I mean, I started off streaming with Chrono Trigger, so...
He was captured trying to protect you. While we're all glad Klaus rescued you, you shouldn't have been so careless as to leave the Countess.
I'm sorry. I was a bad girl. And now Riri's gone.
Well, I suppose there's little point in scolding you after the fact.
Nope, it wasn't Sly Cooper. It was Chrono Trigger. Considered one of the best RPGs of all time, so...
That's more than enough. Not even Raimi would be angry with you, Limmel.
Edgy.
Besides, I'm partially responsible for this myself. It was a mistake to split us up under conditions like these. I won't make that mistake again.
Exactly, though. Chrono Trigger is one of the best, very best RPGs I've ever played.
It's nearly impossible to get into the base from outside. Why don't you leave this part to me?
It is.
What do you mean?
We'll pretend that I've apprehended you, and that I'm bringing you in. That should allow us to get inside without causing too much fuss.
I see. Yes, that would certainly allow us to avoid unnecessary trouble. But one question remains.
Which is?
What exactly is your motive for assisting us? Forgive me, but you're far too knowledgeable about what's happening here. What if he hands us all over together? Are you that kind of man, Klaus?
You have every right to doubt me. But even so, I want to help you.
All right. In that case, I'll leave our method of entry into the base to you, Klaus.
Edge!
Klaus saved Limmel after all. And Limmel isn't the kind of girl who would get this close to someone who couldn't be trusted. But more than anything else, I trust him. Like I said, he came to us unarmed, and he turned his back on us without hesitation.
Actually,
it would appear you have lost again,
there we go.
Mr. Faze.
That's a lot better for my cam.
Indeed.
Thank you. You may have already suspected this, but the truth is, I once worked at the base myself, as a scientist. I was involved with research into a certain field. My field was...
Though I'm a lurk now, I'm a play some sly Reconius Vivius Cooper. Yeah, do that, man. Thanks for the lurk.
Mr. Bucktine,
really appreciate it.
Are you implying that the existence of extraterrestrials is known on this planet?
Well, not by the public, of course. And that's exactly why the researchers must be having trouble controlling their excitement right about now.
Why would that be?
It's not very often they get their hands on an unscathed ship like your Calness. Not to mention uninjured extraterrestrials. If they can understand your technology and make it their own, these people who once struggled in obscurity can suddenly become heroes. Two birds with one stone. Your super technology, their fame. They'll be able to go public. They do it without even stopping to consider how dangerous such advanced technology might be. What kind of scientist would accept a breakthrough handed to him on a plate? We need to catch up with you on our own. Through our own abilities. To be honest, our species just isn't ready for your technology. So once you've rescued your friend, I want you to leave this planet as soon as possible. If I must have a motive, I suppose that would be it.
I see.
Actually, there's one other thing I need to ask. As it happens, There's another extraterrestrial besides your friend who's being held captive in the base.
There are extraterrestrials on Earth other than us?
Yes, a young girl named Miracle.
Kitty!
She has ears and a tail that look just like that cat's. You'll know her when you see her. I beg of you, take Miracle back to her home planet.
You have my word. We'll do our best to get her home.
Thank you.
Yep, that will be another character. Let's see. Oh, there's a chest behind here. Oh, it's unable to. Alright. Touch. There's more chests. And there is a chest in front of the gas station now. That chest wasn't there. Closer, the soldiers will notice us. We better stay away from them for now. Yeah. Phone up, head over there. So let's first get the chest, if I can. Protection seeds. Let's see, use items. Protection seeds. Guards. Guard up.
As per arrangements, from here on out, I will hold onto your weapons and conceal myself.
Baki. Baki disappeared. Is that symbology?
It's optical camouflage.
Incredible to think such advanced technology has been perfected.
I'll feel much safer indeed with Bacchus watching our backs.
No kidding.
Excuse me for just a moment. I need to call in. It's me, Mila. Yes, I'm getting by. I thought I might cooperate with you today. I'm serious. Not being able to work convinced me that you were right.
Think they know each other?
Sounds that way to me.
I brought a little something we can use to continue our research together. That's right. I'd like permission to enter. A03. Understood. Get the entrance, would you?
Wow. was amazing.
Getting in alone would have been difficult indeed.
The base is below. Whenever you're ready.
Let's make sure to save it. Yeah, let's go. Let's go in.
We've been waiting for you, Professor Boktide. Your presence here will undoubtedly speed the director's research along immeasurably.
Mila hasn't changed, has she?
Certainly not, sir. Our sublime director continues her research for the sake of her country.
I see you people haven't changed either. This technology is beyond your understanding.
I knew you would return, Professor. And hell, three more extraterrestrials? You're on a roll, huh? And weren't you the one who tamed that creature with detail, too? Boy, sure is good to have you back, sir. Get inside, you aliens. Let's hope you prove to be of some use to us.
Sit tight while I get this room unlocked. Once you're free, hurry and rescue Miracle and your friend.
Move, damn it!
All right. There is one problem.
Come on, let's go.
This facility houses highly dangerous experimental creatures. With the locks released, they'll be able to get out as well.
It's not going to be a problem. We'll use the panic to our advantage. Don't worry about us. We may not look it, but we've been through a lot worse. Please be careful, Klaus. Once you've released the locks, get out as soon as you can.
Nobody heard or noticed that.
Good luck.
You too.
Take on, Mr. Edge. Let us wait for the signal. This one will begin, right? We need to make this work the first time. It will not do to tense up too much, however, keep yourself loose. Focus on what lies ahead, and you will find success in all that you do. Leave the rear to me, I'll keep you covered. I got it, thanks again. What's that alarm?
Subjects may have escaped, huh?
Well, in that case, let's not disappoint them. Bacchus!
As you wish.
Raimi, we're coming for you!
You've betrayed the director and us! Not once, but twice.
Releasing the test subjects? What the hell were you thinking? You'll kill us all!
You're a little late. Think of all you've done. You knew this would happen. When you play with forces stronger than yourself, you get bitten.
Shut up!
recapture the test subjects!
Aww. Oh, yeah, Ocarina.
Miracle. Please. Get back to space. We don't deserve your...
Oh. He died. Let's see. There's a big guy over here. Let's just kill anything we see. Ow. Ow, ow.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Useful experience indeed.
All right, two new mobs. But yeah, this is gonna be the main reason why I'm doing all the monsters, so I at least get all the mobs down. I hope to get a double kill there.
I could have done this all by myself.
But it's fine. It's fine, I guess. Let's see. There is a room over here. But nothing in it. This was the room I was in. Good backflip. I did a perfect backflip, almost. Almost a perfect backflip. This was the room I was in. Now we have this room. Today, big guy. And a new mob. There we go.
I was just getting warmed up. Bring him on.
This feels pretty good, Kay.
And there is a chest over here. Oh, scan enemy, the new Hey, Exusion, how are you doing? Welcome in. What have you been up to? This. You just get up. Oh, yeah. What time is it for you there now? Because it's probably like really early in the morning. Yeah, I've been doing good. I've worked my last day today, and now I have vacation for 4 weeks. So 1:30 p.m. Wow. It's like a completely different time. Yeah, you're 6 hours behind, so... Because here it's already 7:30 p.m. Oh, that is terrible. And this is even more terrible. But yeah, do you have any plans today? Do you have any plans? The increase in my combat. Let's see. There's a mob over here. Of course my board is broken again. These things attack like so fast. Probably do some exercise later on. Oh yeah, you were sleeping on all those dumbbells and stuff, right? You're gonna do some practice for Castlevania with Resident and stuff later on. Compact freezing bomb. Yeah, the new character. Nice.
Suppose you were...
My ears hurt, Kay.
Yeah, that is probably like one of my one of the characters that I'm going to do main.
She does fit the description.
She must have believed us to be her enemies. This is not a desirable situation, Mr. Edge.
Yeah, this hallway is crawling with those test subjects. She'll be in serious danger if we don't protect her.
Wait up, Kitty.
Let's follow.
Ooh. so many mobs. What the hell? But yeah, I'm just like powering through. Instead of like probably using stuff that I could use to be better at this. Ah, stop running! Could you please stop that? Especially the comet punch, yes, she has. It does a lot of damage. Yeah, I need to figure it out like later on again, because it's been a really, really long time since I last played this game. But the furthest I probably got is when FaZe leaves the party. That, like, stuff like that I hate. You're like in the middle of your melee and then you just get shirked. Because, yeah, they can. And like this, that I can't do anything. That I can't even dodge away, I can't attack them. That is the only thing I really dislike about this game. Now that I think about it, I haven't gotten the secret ending. Yeah, I most likely won't be going for that too. Oh, an earth ring. What did I miss in here? Thornberries, blueberries, aquaberries. Nobody has poison. Thornberries. There we go. Now I should be able to get them. Experience does not no guards. Another skill. Alien Arc. Let's see, equip. All right, that was probably for the new character then or something, or for Raimi, maybe. You can use that then. But yeah, like I said, I probably won't be going for the secret ending. Even though I maybe should. Trade and skill and a Tevita ribbon. Let's see, is that equipable item, the Tafita ribbon. Let's make sure to save here. I don't remember what you need to do even to get the secret ending. I didn't even know there was a secret ending. Meow.
I estimate our
come on, let's do it.
Oh, he does stuff like that, all right. What do you mean I got hit? There we go.
All right, nice job. Now that's what I'm talking about.
He did break my old board again.
This feels pretty good, Kay.
Are you all right? Miracle?
That was for rescuing me. Sorry for getting spooked and running off. My name is Miracle Shamot. Who are you?
Edge Maverick.
I'm Lim.
Bacchus D79.
My name is Faye Shifa Baleth.
That tickles, Kay. That was also for rescuing me. Meow. Just my imagination? Why do you all smell like the professor?
The professor? You mean Klaus, right?
Yeah. Oh, you must be the professor's friends. Is he doing okay?
Well, actually, Klaus asked us to take you back to your home planet.
We're extraterrestrials too. You can trust us.
Like he said, come with us.
I don't even know what planet I'm from.
You don't know what planet you were born on?
Nope, The first thing I can remember is being on a spaceship I'd never seen before.
Wait, so you mean you were stowing away then?
That's what they seem to think. But they were all so nice to me. But then... we got sucked into a black hole and the ship was totaled. They pushed me into an escape pod and I survived. They all helped me get out of there before even thinking about their own safety. They were all such good people. Mary. Anyway, do you know if the professor's here?
Mr. Bakhtine brought us inside this base. However, we parted ways with him on the way here.
I imagine he's still inside the base.
Then take the professor into space with you too!
Take Klaus?
I got caught when my escape pod crashed on this planet. They locked me up and did all kinds of experiments on me. But the professor was nice to me, so I don't want to leave him here.
Well, what do you think we should do, Edge?
Well, I can't make a decision for Klaus. We'll have to find out what he wants. Anyway, Raimi is priority one right now. We have to save her.
If you're looking for someone, let me help you. You helped me after all.
Huh? No, you don't...
Let's go! Meow! Meow.
Yay. Let's see. Characters. Oh, that's... Or did I need to do that? Makes me wish there was a continuation to this game. Yeah, it does. You do. There is the game Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness. Still need to start that one. But it's a game by itself, and all the Star Ocean games are actually like pretty much games by themselves.
The Calnus? They must have brought it in while we were on our way here.
Their transportation technology is actually quite impressive.
Stop! Who told you to point guns at them? I am the chief director of this base. My name is Mila Bakhtine. Welcome to our planet, friends from the stars.
So you're the one in charge of this operation, then?
Yes. I hope you will forgive my subordinates' disrespect.
Huh? No, likewise.
Edge, did you hear what she said? She just called herself Bakhtine.
Are you...
Yes. Klaus is my husband. Or rather, he was my husband. Foolish sentimentality kept me from changing my last name.
This could be difficult.
Yeah.
What's wrong, Mary?
I don't like that woman.
I don't blame you for hating me. I'm not asking you to understand, but I had no choice.
You had no choice? What do you mean by that? We fought a lot of monsters to get here. You people call them test subjects. And this girl, Miracle, she tells me you kept her locked up and that you did work on her too. You made the decisions. You had a choice.
I understand that my work here might be considered inhumane. The guilt was what pushed Klaus to leave this place. But unfortunately, I have crossed the point of no return. There is something I must protect, no matter how much shame it brings me.
And what's that? Your professional name?
Certainly not. I must protect our planet Earth. The situation on our Earth is very different from the future you hail from. Our energy is nearly depleted. In fact, it may not even last for more than a few years.
Wait a minute! You just said the future!
Despite the uniform, I am a scientist. Such a deduction is not beyond my means. Though I must admit, Miss Sionji's information was the key to making that deduction.
What have you done with Raimi? Is she safe?
I assure you, I have not harmed her in any way. She seemed rather exhausted from her ordeal, so I've given her a room to rest in.
I see.
If you will allow me to continue, to solve the looming energy crisis, our world has its eyes on a certain type of energy. The most powerful force known to man. If you're from the future, I'm sure you know what that is.
The most powerful energy in 1957. Nuclear!
Exactly. But what will come of relying on an energy source that could destroy the world? That's why I'm here. I seek a safer, more complete source of energy. I research extraterrestrial technology for the sake of that ideal.
That may be, but I cannot agree with your methods.
Yes, I understand. However, for the people of Earth, and for the sake of all those yet unborn.
Wait, are you?
The world in which you come from surely must have surmounted its energy problems long ago. Indeed, I am sure the people of your time live upon their Earth in perfect harmony. The people of this Earth need extraterrestrial technology. An energy source so perfect, it brings with it no pollution.
A non-polluting energy source? What if, and I stress if, what if you had that power right now? Would this planet...
If we had that power, the planet would surely remain blue forever. That is what I and everyone else here wish for.
You're saying we could change the future?
Edge?
You're saying the Earth could stay blue, stay beautiful.
Absolutely. If you would but help us.
Supposing we can never get back to our own Earth. If we could make a better future.
Yes, a beautiful future.
All right, what do we have to do?
How can we save this planet? How can we save this planet's future?
Mr. Edge. Do you understand what it could mean to alter the course of the future?
History could end up changing completely. Edge, this could affect you directly.
And it's not just you. Something may happen to Miss Raimi as well.
I know. But I also know what happens to Earth. My Earth. With its uninhabitable surface. That broken Earth is my home.
And even if I could never go back there, this is the least I could do.
Edge.
Your ship, the Calnus, right? It's quite a wonderful vessel. I'm going to be as direct as I can. Will you allow me to analyze its control core?
Control core?
She must mean the exolithium crystal. It's true. They're an absolute necessity for the generation of mass energy.
Promise me this. You have to stop your inhumane research on extraterrestrials.
If you encounter any more, you have to promise to work together with them.
And most importantly, I need your word that you'll do nothing to contaminate this beautiful planet.
I wouldn't have it any other way. That is the very goal of our research.
We can trust you, right?
Nope.
Thank you very much.
Ready the equipment. We will begin experiments immediately.
Ma'am!
Please, come with me.
I might actually play this game again either later on tomorrow. Yeah, it is a good game. It really is.
What's in here?
Please, feel free to relax in here, along with Miss Sionji.
Raimi, she's inside?
Come, step inside.
Big mistake.
What did you do to her?
Ah, the room. It moved.
No way. Mila, what are you doing?
Like I said before, I have not harmed Miss Sionji in any way. All I did was calm her down a bit. And she told me so many interesting things. For instance, Mr. Maverick, I learned that you and your crew came from the future. And about your antimatter engine.
You tricked us!
That's not a very gentlemanly way to put it. If my experiments are successful, everything will be within our country's grasp. There will be no more need for inhumane research.
What?
Of course we'll be happy to work together with those from other worlds, as their rightful rulers. We will rule them, and they will serve us. And rest assured, this planet will not be contaminated. We will no longer need to damage the Earth in order to destroy our enemies.
No. Why? That's...
That looks like very bad news.
Hey, what is that thing?
It's an antimatter reactor.
They're normally used with exolithium crystals to control pair annihilation, thus producing tremendous amounts of energy.
But that reactor is far too crude and primitive to function properly. Proper control of the pair annihilation will be impossible. An overload is inevitable.
Well, aren't we being tart? I'd appreciate it if you didn't underestimate me. I built the ultimate system together with Klaus.
And we are the brightest minds of the century.
Yes, And our precious son is just the same. Ah, Kevin. Our beautiful, beautiful Kevin. Mother is going to breathe new life into you now. And don't worry. I'm sure your father will join us. I can hear you. I can hear your first cry. My beautiful son.
He's crazy.
She's insane. She's been insane. All along.
What are we to do, Mr. Edge? If the reactor overloads, it will be the end of us all.
What am I supposed to do?
He's naked.
Edge?
Raimi, thank God.
What happened? That's right. I was captured and then they...
Raimi, no, I didn't mean to.
I didn't mean to, but I'll keep looking.
So all that happened while I was out?
Even if we were able to stop the reactor, it's too late now. There's going to be a massive paranihilation.
What's going to happen to us?
The paranihilation will reduce this base. No, the entire planet, to nothing more than formless energy.
Isn't there anything?
Why did you get the clothes from to give to her?
They opened it themselves. A Pandora's box they have...
Emmer Space.
Closing.
But it's not a box they could have opened alone. I let them open it. I gave them the key. It's all my fault!
No! Edge, you did it because you wanted to save the future!
That's no excuse at all! Look at what I've done! The Earth is going to be destroyed! It's all my fault!
Edge, this is not the time nor the place for you to be talking like that.
FaZe,
you have a duty to perform. Don't leave it unfulfilled.
You have to make a decision, Mr. Edge. Not as a guilty man, but as a captain. Our captain.
Bacchus. We have to leave this place now. We have to get the hell off this planet.
All right, so it was my fault if I didn't get reacted sooner. What's that sound?
I knew it. It's the sound of my ocarina.
I don't hear anything. Kay?
No. I know that sound. I gave it to the professor. The wall. Check it out, everyone.
Is that?
If we follow this walkway, we should be able to reach the Calnus.
Professor, where are you?
I'm here, Miracle.
Professor!
Miracle, I'm glad you're safe. And I'm happy to see you well.
Professor, you look like you've lost some weight.
Oh, Return to space. Return to space with your new friends.
If I'm going with you.
I can't, Miracle. It's Mila. There's something I have to tell her.
Professor? Wait! Professor!
Miracle, we have to go.
No! Let me go! The professor's coming! We're leaving with the professor!
We have to run! We have to go! That's enough, Mila. Please, understand. Kevin wasn't your fault. I'm sorry I left you when you were in such pain. But we both know our son wouldn't have wanted this. Let's make that boy's dream a reality. Let's work towards friendship with all extraterrestrials. And let's do it through our own abilities, not through technology beyond our means.
Yes, that sounds wonderful, Klaus. I'm sure that would make him happy.
It is dangerous outside. Let's save. Here we go.
I estimate our combat.
Here I come.
Still seem to have hidden potential.
Oh, there's a chest over here. Plasma cannon. And I saw another chest over there.
We must make the most of
hey. Of course. Oh yeah, why not? Why not break my board while you're at it? Alright, I can't do anything here. Yeah, it's really annoying, and it keeps getting worse as you progress through the game. Some bomb. I did get a plasma cannon. It should be good for him, yeah. Oh, maybe I can. No, I can't. How the hell were you supposed to get your party composition? I guess that can only be done on save points.
Come on, get over here!
I'm staying here with the professor. I don't have any other friends.
You do! We're right here!
Huh?
You have friends! Right here!
Edge.
Yeah, I'm trying to change party members, but... I couldn't find it.
Miracle!
Without an exolithium crystal, we can't escape this gravitational field with our normal engines.
No, we made it this far.
Is this the end?
Just wait a little longer, Miracle. I'm going to get you back home, to space.
But you'd be lonely if I left, wouldn't you, Professor? After all, you don't have many friends. So, here, Professor. Whenever you get lonely, you can use it to remember me, okay?
Well, then let me give you this in return.
Wow, wow! It's such a pretty pendant!
It's a delicious crystal.
Space. One day, I'm sure it will be of use to you.
Hey! You don't think this would help, do you?
What do you expect us to do with the pendant? Wait! It can't be! Where did you get such a high density? Yes, with this we could...
Edge, make preparations for warp!
But we have one! An extremely high-density exolithium crystal! I've never seen anything like it! Warp engines, online! We can leave on your order!
Amazing! I've never seen this kind of power!
How fascinating. I'd certainly like to study this in detail when we have time.
Thank you, Professor. Come on, let's take off!
Edgy.
Kalnis, engage!
Okay, now I remember how to change party members. So, alright. And thus a black hole was born. Open your menu and go to characters and select tactics. Alright.
Coordinates, star systems, I've cross-referenced 147 categories of data. There's no question we've returned to the time period we originally came from. We managed to make it home.
How did they do that?
This is mere speculation, but the spatial collapse may have served to thrust us back to the time from which we came. Unfortunately, I cannot be certain.
Thank you for looking that up, man. Appreciate that.
We extraterrestrials are one thing, but given the fact that you two Earthlings have not vanished from existence, perhaps that planet existed in a different dimension. An alternate Earth that was not your own.
That would mean...
I saw it. Just before we entered subspace, Earth twisted. And disappeared in a flash of light. 4.6 billion years after having miraculously survived for 4.6 billion years, it was annihilated in a single instant, just like that. So simply.
A pair annihilation overload cannot be stopped. Nobody could have prevented what happened.
Oh yeah? You know how it could have been prevented? If I hadn't started it in the first place!
No, Edge, that's not true!
Edgy.
Edge, you did your best!
Don't try to console me, damn it!
Yeah, we got the ship working. Let's wreck it.
It wasn't our Earth. It doesn't even matter. It's gone. Either way. You get it? It's all gone forever! My bad judgment pushed those people over the edge! The Earth was annihilated! Every last speck! Everything! Everything! People, children, animals, towns and houses and everything!
Everything!
Did he mention everything?
Please stop. Stop, Kay.
I didn't go into space for this. I went for mankind's future. It's happiness. Damn it all!
Mr. Edge, the responsibility isn't yours alone. All of us were at fault here.
Yes, Arcus is right. None of us were able to prevent this from happening. Please, Edge.
If I hadn't been there... If I hadn't handed over our technology!
Edge, if you really mean that, then what about me? I finally made some new friends. You asked me to come with you, but... Mary...
Yeah, I got the trophy. Aww. There we go. Well, time to do some boring stuff. Characters, tactics. Ah, yeah, there it is. Face out. Limo is actually the. So yeah. It's basically tank, ranged, DPS, and heat, and mage. Now for the boring stuff. Oh. Is it down again? Terrible. Then no boring stuff, I guess. The warp engine is currently in a state of overflow. We cannot warp at this time. I believe it is best to land on nearby planet of Rogue for maintenance. Will that be satisfactory? Yeah, alright, do that.
I've entered the coordinates for our course to Rogue. Mr. Edge, we can leave on your order. Mr. Edge?
Kalnus, departing for Rogue. Engage, please.
Right.
Vineyard at your service.
Yeah? Who the heck?
Hi there, Welchy. You're all 2D today.
Hi yourself, Pipsqueak. Looking cute as always. Oh? What? What's this? I turn around for a minute and now you've got a cat? And not just any cat, apparently. I mean, look at those ears. Yeah! I feel like I just walked into an anime convention.
What the heck is she talking about? This is just how well she is, Kay.
Welch, right?
You got that right, sister! So how have you all been? I've been trying to get through to you guys forever!
You couldn't get through to us?
Yeah! Where'd you all run off to anyway?
Huh? Wait a second!
Should know better than to keep secrets from Auntie Welch. Come on, spill the beans.
Sorry, Welch. We're kind of busy right now. Talk to you later. If Welch contacted us, that means...
Yes. Bacchus's hypothesis was correct. It would seem we were in a different dimension after all.
Your homeworld has not been destroyed. In this universe, your Earth still exists.
Did you hear that, Edge? Earth is... our Earth. It's safe.
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
What?
It doesn't change the fact that the other Earth was destroyed. It doesn't change the fact that I destroyed it.
Edge.
Billions of people have died, but you're all happy because we're safe? That makes us no better than the Cardianon.
That was... look, it couldn't have been helped.
If only I hadn't handed over the exolithium crystal.
How can you continue to go on like this?
Stop it, both of you.
Face says one thing and it's immediately stop it.
My immaturity once caused me to lose much while I was attempting to fulfill my duty as Amorphous. I have experienced much agony and regret, and yet I have never found a complete answer. But I live with the belief that one day I will find that answer. Mr. Edge, you may have much worry and regret, but keep moving forward nonetheless. If you let it hold you back, you will simply molder away.
The ship! We're under attack!
Attack? But why would anybody...
Forgive me, Miss Raimi. I'm afraid to say... I was somewhat careless.
Putting it up now!
FaZe, can you check their ship's registry?
They're... not registered! It's not from Earth or from Eldar.
I'm detecting a strong energy burst. We can't dodge it! What's that?
That ship. It's from the 13th Independent Armored Division. An Eldarian vessel.
You're those civilians from back on Eos, aren't you?
Hey, he's that... you have our thanks for rescuing us.
I'm only chasing my prey. If you get in the way, I'll shoot you down, too. Stay out of this if you value your lives, amateurs.
Well, that wasn't very nice.
I wouldn't take it personally. The 13th Independent Armored Division aren't exactly known for their kindness.
But still, what do you think that black ship was?
That I cannot say, but I can say what we must do next. Damage may be light, but nevertheless, we have sustained an attack. We must check the ship and perform maintenance.
I suppose that gives us another reason to land on Roke. Are we able to navigate?
The attack produced a slight alteration in our course, but it should be easy enough to correct.
Please take care of it. Very well. Let us continue toward Planet Roke.
Preparations for landing on Roke complete. Your orders, Captain. Edge, your orders.
I judge the Captain to be unfit for command, and hereby exercise my rights as second-ranking officer.
Henceforth, I assume command of the Calnus as acting captain. Are there any objections?
I don't object, but do we really have to land on Roke?
Our reasons for landing are all valid.
Bacchus, if you will.
Our new exolithium crystal is putting too much stress on the ship's generators. It will take no small amount of time to recalculate our energy conversion matrix. Upon landing, we must put the ship's systems into sleep mode to complete the recalculation as quickly as possible.
And don't forget checking the ship and performing maintenance duties.
And above all, our original SRF mission takes utmost precedence. Investigating habitable planets is the reason we began our journey in the first place.
But...
that is all. Begin the landing sequence.
So this is Roke. Yes, its civilization level is, well, by Earth standards, it would be roughly equivalent to the Middle Ages. Naturally, our level of technology would be an impossibility here. I don't want to interfere with anyone. Yes, Mr. Edge, for that reason, I have installed optical camouflage devices on the Calnus and hidden it from sight. It will camouflage myself as well. Yes, please. Well then. Let's start looking around. Let's first see if Welch is working already. Yep, he is working again.
Sorry.
Hey, what kind of an attitude is that? You're the one who called me. Come on, man, you've got to loosen up. Forget about everything and just go with the flow like this. Go, go, go.
Yeah.
Yay, yay, yay.
You're right. Sorry.
No, 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 wrong answer. I'm the one who's going with the flow here, me. Me, what the heck are you apologizing for?
Oh, I guess so. Sorry.
Yeah. Look, I don't have any idea what happened to you, but you need to lighten up a bit, okay? I'm getting tired of this! You're not gonna make anything nice with an attitude like that! Sally forth, SRF! Fight on, SRF! You're the star of hope on which the future of planet Earth rests! Look, eat a good meal, get some good sleep, and get back to being good old Edge, alright?
Sorry, Welch.
Yo, people! How's it going? Show me the good stuff.
Let's start with this.
I did it.
Meowrika. Okay, one more combination.
Don't forget to psych yourselves up.
No, that was it.
I can tell an awesome recipe is on the way. Already know what you want to make?
I'm going for some chips and dip. And meanwhile, hydrate. Thank you. Looks like that's it for now. Yeah, it might be it. Cheers. But I can also do one more thing, which is skill boosts. And get my smithery up. Crafting to the maximum. Cooking still not. I can't get that yet. Alright. But yeah, that is a lot. Gotta keep hydrating or you will, funny enough, dehydrate. Oh, before I go, I gotta ask. Is the character Edge a dark? Or is Edge an Edge Knight? That's edginess. Like a wise man once said. That is all. But yeah, he's neither a Dark Knight, he's neither or a Edge Knight, and he's not edginess. He's edgy, actually. And he's a swordsman. Yeah, I could actually save here. Then There we go. When you got edge, was there an edge to it, or could you have chosen another character? Are we going to do like it's really, really I don't know even what to say anymore. I need a break now. I'm actually gonna take like a 5-minute break, stretch up a little, and then I'll be back. Due to stiffness and stuff. I'm getting a little edgy. So, I'll be right back. See you all in a little bit. Alright, I'm back. And I'm actually... Nether, are you still here? And also Exusion? Because I have something that is on a different level of ashiness. Let me know in chat if you're still here. Then I'll show you something. Let's see, where do we go? Alright, this map is kind of weird. Oh, that is the Kelness, of course, yeah. That is why it seems weird. But yeah, like I said, if you guys are still here, then let me know. There's something that I want to show you that is on a different... That's like different to the game. Here we go. Sage. Alright, that kind of hurt. So, yeah, from next week onward, I will try and beat this game either tomorrow or Monday. Please step back. But from next week onward, I will most likely start with Sword Art Online. And from next week onward, I just said that I will most likely start with Sword Art Online and then play through the whole saga. And hopefully get all the games done in my vacation. So I will most likely be playing like longer hours than I used to. Which I'm not kind of used to do like long hours. Yeah, we want to get her up.
Getting stronger all the time.
Do we have anything here? No. A tail. He's got tail and ears just like yours, Mary. Morphous data does indeed indicate that most inhabitants of Rogue are tailed. Now that you mention it, that other person has a tail as well. So, do you think Mary is home planet? The probability would seem high. Isn't it great, Mary? Mary? I don't know. Huh? Well, it does smell kind of like where I was born, but there's also something different about it. Could it be an issue with the composition of the atmosphere? It's such a small difference, I don't know. Anyway, let's keep looking around for a while. Is it okay if I stay with you guys? Yes, of course. We'll go together, Kay. Thanks, that makes me happy. So, what shall we do now? Well, Why don't we see if we can find some sort of settlement? I'd like to see what level of civilization is here. Of course, undue contact and interference is not permitted under any circumstance. Nor may we reveal our origins. I'm asking you all to operate within the bounds of common sense. And I saw a chest here, so let's steal that. I'm planning to take a ship to the land across the sea, but I'm waiting for my friend to arrive first. Where is she? I hope she comes back soon. Hello there, my name is Autumn. Autonym. I used to be a simple medicine salesman, but as I journey by foot from town to town, I started to wonder if there is something better I could do with my time. So now I'm a traveler. I'm drawing pictures as a side hobby and chasing after a brand new set of dreams. I need to be over there, all the way over there. See if there's anything down there. Oh, look, a new enemy. Yeah, I got a new enemy. Edit. Let's see, I still can't see what's down there. Do the burp.
Please step back.
Oh, an enemy. I didn't see that one coming. What does Basil do? Cures paralysis. Cures poison. HP for party. Alright, I can only jump off there. And that's it. Pretty silly. Oh, that is a lot of gil. A lot of money. Alright, where do I need to go? There's a chest down there. That chest? No, I have to walk all the way around for that chest to get. It's fine though. Ah, cutscene.
It's a big, huge rabbit?
It was so round and meaty. Didn't it look yummy?
It must be easy for it to navigate these mountains. I'm envious. Don't you think so too, Edge?
Sure.
Let's get moving.
Rabby, wait up, Kay?
Hold on! I just want one teensy-weensy bite!
Edge?
What the?
I don't know what happened there. And think, buddy. Oh yeah, now that you're here, let me actually show you. So years back when the game first came out, I actually got this for myself. I did have a lot more, but yeah, like fully posable figures of both Edge and Raimi. And they're like really detailed and stuff. Like even the back sides are pretty cool. But yeah, these two I got like years back on a convention. I don't know if you can still get them. They probably might be really like a little bit more expensive now, but I don't think too expensive. But yeah, those are really neat. And that is kind of how much I loved this game back then. get that chest first. No, I don't want to fight you. I just want the chest and then return. Alright, potion. But yeah, I think for the posable figures, there's only Action Raimi. But you also have like a mini art set, which has Edge, Raimi, Face, Limmel, and what's her face called? Miracle. I used to have them, but I sold them back in the day. And in the end, I actually want to complete, like, one of my goals with streaming is that any bit of money I make with it is going back in, either back into the stream or going towards new games or merchandise to show off. So, like, everything is going into back into the streams. Just keep your cool and we'll be in a certain way. And other than that, it's just playing games. Sounds like you got everything planned out. Well, it is kind of a plan, but I don't expect, like, to get anything. So every bit that is there is only, like, good. I mean, let's just put it like this. It took me like well over a year to get enough money together to get a new mic, so I don't expect anything to happen really quick. In the end, it's all about the fun. Just keep your cool. There will be some stuff added soon, though, but it will probably most likely be too expensive to actually work out. Let me put it like this. One of the plans that I have is that I'm gonna add in the nearby future is instead of a redeem to suggest me a game to play, you can actually like donate a game that you suggest me to play. How much it's gonna cost, I'm not sure yet, but it's most likely gonna be like around 50 or 60. So that I can at least buy the new game that you want me to play. Three of those. That hurts. Especially if he does it two or three times consecutively. Come on. Cure sparalysis. What do you mean she can't do anything? Fresh Sage, you stand up. There we go. But yeah, that is a plan that I'm... That is something that I'm planning on, but I'm not sure if I should do it. Because like I said, it is kind of expensive to just ask for like $60 to be able to buy the new game, and then... So someone actually donating it, and then me having to play it, even though I might not like it. Oh, there's another target. Oh, there's multiple targets even still. I must say, leveling goes fast in the remastered version. Seems to be going faster than it used to be. There is a chest and a gathering point here. Come on. Let's see, I have to go down there.
Here we go.
There's a chest over there and a chest over there. All right. Danger, do not drink. I want to drink that now. Which side should I go? Let's first check this out for a second. Oh, this is the town actually. So I should have been here. Most likely. Welcome back, Miller. You just missed me doing a little show off with merchandise. With etchy merchandise, actually.
What a strange manner of dress.
The townspeople seem to be ignoring them.
And do I have to be afraid for the question?
They don't have anything to do with us.
No, he doesn't have the edge of darkness. He has edge of edginess. It's an unusable skill.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Be careful.
I'd better stay sharp.
Oh, nice. Actually, shops and stuff to buy stuff again. Buy items. Liquor. This is all that sort of stuff. Let's just accept all those orders. Sharp like my jokes. Yeah, they're really edgy. You're a new one around here, aren't you? Oh, yeah. Let's see. Oh, tents. If I were to buy 18, then I would be out of gil. Gunpowder, matter. Oh, a repair kit. Yeah, so this is like all the stuff that I need later on to start creating stuff. As edgy as they come, if they become more edgy, they actually transform into cringe. Yeah. This is probably like an inn room, I guess. Yeah, this is an inn. So I might return here in a little bit. Oh, never mind.
What was that?
It sounded like someone said, ah! Was it a scream?
For a scream, I'd say it lacked a sense of urgency.
Oh dear, please stop. Somebody save me.
I've verified that the source of the voice is located up ahead. I'm detecting a number of life signs in its vicinity.
I knew it was a scream meow!
Edge! Regardless of the situation, we can't ignore a cry for help.
But I...
Pull yourself together, man.
Somebody! Please!
Unhand that woman!
What cowards.
Damn it all!
I'm not supposed to be doing this, but... Damn it! Get out of here. I'm telling you to get lost! Just go!
Are you sure it was best to let them go? Should we not have at least turned them over to the authorities on this planet?
What the hell am I doing? No contact. No interference. That's what I swore.
Edge. Yeah, they already gave up quickly.
If someone asks for help, you help. That's just the way you are, Kay? So,
Why do you look like you want to cry, Edgy? You haven't done anything bad.
You know, if only Edge could think as simply as you, Limmel.
Are you making fun of me?
Oh dear! Whatever am I doing? Me and my manners. I haven't even thanked you for rescuing me yet. My name is Sarah Durand. I appreciate your help.
They moved. Those are real wings.
Oh, chicken. So yummy. No. I can assure you, I'm not chicken, nor am I yummy.
Miracle is awesome.
I see. So you're all on a journey together. Well, I must say, I'm so fortunate you came to my aid.
Please, just stop.
Pardon?
I didn't have any intention of saving you. I didn't mean to get involved.
But the end result is that I was rescued, right? I really, truly must give you my thanks.
Oh?
Is there something on my face? My. I've just remembered.
You remembered? What did you remember?
Yes. Raimi and Edge, did you say? I was just thinking that I'd seen your faces somewhere before. Then I remembered. It was at the Purgatorium.
Well now, this sounds interesting indeed.
Yes, the Purgatorium is located in the northwest of this continent. It's the most historic structure there is. Oh my! Are you a giant? What a large man you are!
That's what she said.
Blast.
Good heavens! The giant suddenly disappeared!
You're a little slow on the uptake. Both of you.
So, what did you mean when you said you've seen us before?
The stone statues in the Purgatorium. They're statues of the Muwa, you see. But they look very much like you.
Muwa?
Some say the Muwa are our ancestors. But now they're like ghosts. Nobody even knows if they exist anymore. You can't tell the history of this land without mentioning the Muwa. There's even an entire continent named after them.
Muwa. Yes, I remember now. I believe it was the Cardinon who referred to Edge and Raimi as descendants of the Muwa.
Yeah.
If the Muwa and Earthlings are somehow connected, do you think Roke might be involved as well?
I see. Yes, that would seem to be a possibility. If that is the case, we may be able to get closer to the origins of both Earth and Roke.
Yes, just thinking about it gets the blood racing.
Baze. You kinda look like Edgy right now.
How about it? I think it'd be worth our while to investigate this Purgatorium. Edge? Raimi?
Yes, you're right. I suppose I'll have to face it eventually.
So, are you all planning to go to the Purgatorium? If so, I'd like to accompany you on your journey. You rescued me. Won't you let me repay you by acting as your guide?
Oh? Are you gonna come with us, Sari? Yay!
If the chicken, I mean Sarah, is coming, then count me in too!
Oh my! Lim seems very nice, but Mary, you're a tad scary.
Well, how about it? It sure would be helpful to have a local to guide us.
Yes, that's definitely true.
Forget it! We can't travel with anyone from this planet. Absolutely not! Right now, I may not be in command, but that is one thing I will not allow!
Edge.
We don't intend to have any more contact with you people. So, if you're done here, please, just go away.
Edge, don't you think you're being too hard on her? Whatever our initial reasons, it is we who made first contact. And Sara is clearly motivated only by kindness.
No, no, don't concern yourself with me. But please, do allow me to be a busybody about one thing. If you don't ride a bunny, there's no way you can get to the Purgatorium.
Bunny? Are you serious?
Some nomads are camping outside the town right now. Why don't you go see them about the bunnies? Maybe they can help you. Very well. Take care of yourselves.
They're not the fastest kind of people.
Let's go.
A giant pink bunny, I don't think I even want to go near it. Yeah. Come to think of it, remember the tent we saw outside of town? You think it belonged to the nomad Sarah mentioned? Yeah, you might be right. I suppose we should take a look. Let's see. There is a chest in this corner. Somewhere. Where did I see it? Oh, there it is. Anti-curse amulet. So if you equip this amulet, you can say stuff like shit, fuck, crap. Weapons there. An item store. Welcome, can I help you? Weapon store is upstairs. Let's see. Bastard sword is up. Seems like everything else is pretty much the same. Wait, this gives me more defense. All right. Oh well. Is there anything else that I should be doing here? There's another item store over here. Do you have... There we go. I'm wondering if it can read. Cures fog, cures frozen. There we go. Just want to max out on that kind of stuff. What do you have? Hit plus 6. Amplifies earth symbols. Immunity to frozen status. Automatically revives and prevents surprise attacks. I'm just gonna buy 2 just in case, because I think I will have to like, this is gonna be actually better. Oh, this actually gives me more pull at the end of a battle. I'm actually gonna give it to him. Why not? Because why not? Can I do anything with this? No, not yet. I still need to get that poison ring. First things first. So I need to get that one guy. Alright, so one of these, one of these. One height, one of these. Illusion is still not. One, two, three, four. And I'm broke again. So let's go to the in room right now. Am I right? No, there's... Oh, that chest I couldn't get yet. And then there's one more chest over there, and then I think we got everything. Yeah, I couldn't get that chest either. We'll stay. So then I'm at least full health. All right. So there's still a second area here, which can be gotten into with a chest. With aqua berries that I cannot get. Oh, this is the backside of the store, I guess. Let's find out where I need to go now. Most likely all the way down there. Or at the encampment, but it's outside. The little tent that is there. There we go.
Well, here we are. Time to find out about these bunnies.
Yeah, she said ride, so I assume they must be pretty big.
I know! Bunnies. They're fluffy and round and yummy looking.
Fluffy?
Wait, you mean like that pink thing we saw in the mountains?
Yep, that was a bunny.
No response. No matter how good your eyesight is, if you're covered in black fog, you'll be done for. I'm not talking about fairy tales either. It happened to me once. Though she got one, she got food on the mind. Yeah. She just wants to take a small bite. That sure was a close one. I don't know what would have happened. If I wasn't carrying this, a glow stick. I already got glow sticks. I swear I always try to cut out of work like that. Hello travelers, I take it. Is there something I can... Hey, what's all the chatter for? I told you to finish this up already. I swear, this is why bunnies keep escaping on us. Yeah, I understand. By the way travelers, did you want to ask me something? Well, it's about the bunnies. Bunnies, you say. In that case, why don't you ask the elder? He should be in front of the tent. I just tried to talk to the dude. Or girl. Dude.
Excuse me? Do you think you could tell us about bunnies?
That sounds like me in the morning. Yeah, that is me in the morning when I have to wake up for work.
I have no idea what he's saying, Kay.
Miracle, can you make it out? If this is your home planet, it's possible that...
No, I can't understand a word.
My Morphous translator is of no use either. This language structure must be quite ancient indeed.
I guess we're stuck.
Visitors? It's you people.
You're that girl from...
Yes, you all wear such unusual clothes. I remember you well. I'm sorry, my grandfather can only speak the ancient tongue. But I can translate, so feel free to ask anything you like.
Well, we're trying to get to the Purgatorium. Someone we met in town told us we had to ride on a bunny to get there.
Nonale da has bosla.
Val bunny. Astra da bosla.
It's true. The only way to cross the desert of quicksands is astride a bunny.
So can we have one? I won't eat it.
Eat it? Of course you won't eat it.
I'm sorry, but I can't let you have our bunny.
Why not?
We consider him to be an important member of the family. He's been with us since he was a baby, after all. You can't just go handing your family over to strangers, can you?
Of course not. I hope you can forgive us for making such a flippant request.
You're a serious one, aren't you? Don't worry. My grandfather isn't angry, and neither am I.
I'm glad.
But what are we supposed to do now?
How about trying to capture a field bunny?
A field bunny?
Wild bunnies that live in the forests near here. If you can catch one, you'll have your very own mount.
Is that even possible?
Yes, of course it is. Even mine was a field bunny once, you know. Here, let me show you. Everyone, this is my bunny. Usually I let him run free in the wild. I only call him when he's needed. He's the first bunny I caught as a child, and he's still a very important friend to me. All right, now run along and play for a while.
Is this like the summoning symbology Lim uses?
Not quite, Miss Raimi. This is somewhat different.
Did you just hear a voice?
Well, you see, Raimi, summoning is actually a sort of contract, so to speak.
Contract?
Only a few particular beings from other worlds can become subject to those contracts. Limmel can only summon one specific creature, right?
Now that you mention it, it is always Cerberus.
The power she just used isn't summoning. It's more like transference. She can freely move any object she wants to another location. Take warp travel. By compressing space, you can reduce the time it takes to travel a certain distance. But as that distance grows, so does the time it takes to cover it.
Faith, no! You can't start talking about warp or...
But that is not how transference works. Transference breaks down the actual data of a physical object, then reconstructs it at any desired location. In other words, the transfer of matter can be accomplished in the blink of an eye, nearly instantaneously. Even we Eldarians haven't managed to achieve that. However, it's much more difficult coordinating transfers for small objects than it is for more massive ones. Considering all that, achieving transference with just a single symbol is astonishing. That's really the only way I can put it.
I've never seen anyone get so excited about this technique before.
And all of you use this ability?
The technique has been passed down through the ages among our tribe, and it's our duty to continue to do so.
Is there a particular reason for that?
I'm afraid nobody really knows.
Nobody?
No. All I can say is that our people have always been called the Openers, and that this technique has been with us for generations.
The Openers? You say?
Nobody remembers why we bear the name. Not even my grandfather and the other elders.
What's this?
Reins for riding a bunny. As long as you have these, you shouldn't have any problem taming one.
Can we really accept something so precious from you?
Of course. All we have to do is make another.
This will be a huge help. Thank you so much.
So, with regards to the transfer technique...
I'm sorry. I'm afraid we can't teach it to outsiders. But if you were to join our tribe...
I'll certainly give the matter consideration.
Well then, we'll be going now. Thank you so much for all your help.
Bye-bye!
Wait a moment, would you?
Yes? This is one of the cloaks the members of your tribe wear.
As long as you have it on, the field bunny shouldn't be as wary of you. I think this particular cloak would fit you best.
He's in love.
I wish there were enough for all of you, but right now this is the only one we have.
Are you certain? Not just the reins, but this cloak as well.
We receive the benefit of much goodwill on our travels, The least we can do is repay those favors, don't you think?
That's a splendid way of thinking. It would be disrespectful to refuse such an offer.
This is actually the furthest I've been in the game, so this is all new for me.
I can't say it's very flattering.
What took so long, FaZe? Huh? What's that weird thing you're wearing?
It was a gift. We're such a rustic and friendly people.
You look really bad in it, Kay.
The girl told me the same thing.
The forest near here that girl was talking about, do you suppose that she meant that place across the bridge? Yeah, probably. Besides, now that I know what bunnies smell like, I bet I could figure it out. That's one reliable nose you got there, Mary. Hmm, FaZe? What's that you're wearing? This? The girl offered it to me. She said it should make the bunnies less wary of us. Hehe, I see. It looks good on you, FaZe. I hope so. At any rate, let's try to catch a bunny. I bet we'll find bunnies around these parts. Wanna look around for a bit? Search for bunnies.
Alright, we're gonna catch one, Kay.
Big and meaty and round and yummy looking!
Food! I hit the neck with a hacky sack. Where'd it come from? Hey, Frodo. How are you doing, man? Welcome in.
What's the matter, Raimi?
What have you been up to today?
Ray, are you okay? Ray?
She's got like a terrible fever. What are we gonna do?
Raimi, don't tell me you've been sick all this time.
I'm fine. It's nothing serious.
We need to get back to Tatroy. There should be a doctor there. Come on!
Playing Assassin's Creed Syndicate and try to play FF and watch Spooderman. How was the movie? Do not spoil it though, but how was it? Is it worth watching? Spider-Man is in it. Yeah, I figured you wanted to say that. But is it worth watching?
That same dream again, having it night after night.
Absolutely, alright. I might check it out tonight then.
I wonder, is my neighbor having a nightmare too?
Raimi.
Sorry.
Huh?
They closed at 22, yeah, but you have something called internet.
It's my fault. I'm sorry. So sorry.
What? Raimi, what are you saying? You don't have anything to apologize for.
Please, don't look at me. Don't look at me like that.
Raimi, hey!
Don't look at me like that. Is she dreaming about the part where she was naked?
I imagine she's apologizing to someone.
So do you do a sheik?
Judging by her condition.
What do you mean you do a sheik?
Hang on, in there, Raimi. We're here with you, okay?
Ray Ray.
Yeah, bye, Ruth Kitty. Arr.
Edge, something's wrong with her.
Ray Ray's hand. It's so hard.
What? Wait, don't tell me. Is it Boculus?
I don't want Ray Ray to end up like Grandpa, Kay.
No, this isn't Boculus. This disease is endemic to Roke.
Endemic to Roke?
It is called stone sickness, and you can see why. It spreads from the extremities to the internal organs, eventually causing death.
How do you know so much about this?
I went through quite a lot in my younger days. But there is no cause for concern. Stone sickness has a...
Yes, a remedy. She'll be just fine if
Hello?
We give her some.
Indeed. Stone
it
sickness was at one
so?
Time an incurable disease. But a treatment does exist.
I'm sure we'll be able to find...
Well, thank you for embarrassing me like that.
Oh, really?
And for those who don't know, that was actually me screaming. Because the ghost actually
Sari?
Turned up right in front of me.
What are you doing here?
I'm staying in the next room over, you see. I wondered what was going on, so I came here, and what a wonderful reunion. Hmm.
It's already that bad?
Oh dear, the symptoms are quite advanced.
Can we cure her?
Yes. It's just like
yeah.
before. If you have the remedy, she'll get better in no time.
I'm glad.
I think she must be exhausted in both mind and body. She's so cute, but she pushes herself too far, doesn't she?
Exhaustion? Raimi. It's my fault yet again. If only I had kept myself together, Raimi wouldn't have.
If you've time to waste on regret, use it to act instead.
Huh?
The only person that regret benefits is yourself. But if you act, others can benefit from your actions.
Doesn't that sound good? I borrowed the saying from someone I respect.
FaZe? If you feel responsible for what happened to Raimi, I believe now is the time to make a decision. Let's go then, to Astral Castle. Let's bring back the remedy we need to cure Raimi.
Alright. I guess we're gonna continue without Raimi then. Oh, that is not the outside door. What time is it at this moment? I'm actually gonna be heading towards the end of my stream. So do not leave yet. We're gonna look someone up. If you have someone that is online right now and you want to suggest that for a raid, do let me know. Do stick around till we have raided, because my viewer numbers will go up, saying that we raid with more people. I will also check myself. So let's see who is actually here. There we go. Anyways, let's rate Nienta. Yeah, sure. Let's rate myself. For those of you who haven't done so yet, you can join my Discord by clicking this link. Then, of course, next to that, there's all sorts of stuff in there where there's going to be more talk about other games than just Final Fantasy. You can mingle in the conversations, of course, and we'll be doing a lot of, yeah, like lots of stuff, actually. Let's see. I actually rated this person yesterday, I think. Oh, I didn't rate this person yesterday. However, yeah, what the hell? We're just gonna rate this person. Doing Final Fantasy Fridays for gaming. A nice person is playing Final Fantasy, because at the moment there's only music players and Final Fantasy players. Slash rates. As you can hear, she is already talking, I think. I will mute this for a little bit. There we go. So, yeah. Thank you all for joining. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for chatting around and sticking around. We will be raiding a Katie, or not Katie Caliber. Harlequin Jester. Do stick around for a little bit. Copy the raid call, and as soon as you come in her chat, just paste it at least once, just for the heck of it, and then decide whether you stay around for a bit or leave. She's playing Final Fantasy 14. She's just doing some random stuff. I think it's Fates at the moment or some main scenario. So yeah, let's have some fun there, and let's check it out and see what she's doing, what she's up to at the moment. Again, thanks for watching, thanks for staying around, and tomorrow I will be continuing Star Ocean. I will put in some more hours tomorrow than I did today, because I actually don't have to wake up early on Sunday. So thanks again, and have a great night, man. Ugh.